Okay. We'll try to wrap this up here in Hosea chapter 4, verse 13. He sacrificed upon the tops of the mountains and burnt incense upon the hills under oaks and poplars and elms, because the shadow thereof is good. Therefore, your daughters shall commit whoredom and your spouses commit adultery. The shadow is good. These things are huge. That's why their shadow was good. An incredible shadow. So we're going to turn here to Isaiah 1 verse 29. Isaiah 1:29 reads, "For they shall be ashamed of the oaks which they have desired, and they shall be confounded for the gardens that they have chosen." Oaks that they have resorted to for idolatrous worship, which is Asherah. Next, let's go to Ezekiel 6:13, chapter 6, verse 13. "Then shall ye know that I am Yahweh, when their slain men shall be among them, shall be among their idols, round about their altars, upon every green hill, and in the tops of the mountains, and under every green tree, and under every thick oak," specifically thick oak, sorry about that, camera's turned up, "every thick oak, the place where they did offer sweet savor to their idols." Savor of appeasement or rest to their idols. So they speak specifically of the thick oaks, especially. The bigger the tree, the more they worshiped it. Okay, let's turn to Ezekiel chapter 20, verse 28. "For when I had brought them into the land, for the which I lifted up mine hand to give to them, then they saw every high hill and all the thick trees." Once again, the bigger the tree, the more they worshiped it. "And they offered there their sacrifices. And there they presented the provocation of their offering. There also they made sweet savor and poured out there their drink offerings." So here we have in Ezekiel, Isaiah, Hosea, Amos, in the time of all these prophets, we still have these giant thick trees of some sort, whether they were these ancient forests or just the remnants are up there. Obviously, the bigger the tree, the more they worshipped it. And even though they'd seen miracles done on the way out of Egypt, they were still offering sacrifices to these Asherahs, these thick trees. So obviously, they were quite taken back by these trees. So it was all wrong. It was all bad. According to tradition, not according to the Bible or scripture, but Jewish tradition, Isaiah himself spent the last part of his life in a hollow mulberry tree where he was hiding and refused to come out. It was that big. And supposedly, they sawed the tree in half in order to get to him. So apparently, he had locked some kind of door on the tree behind him. The army couldn't even get him out. And in order to kill Isaiah, according to tradition, they sawed the mulberry tree in half to kill him. That's supposedly how Isaiah died, according to Jewish writings and such. I think it even has it in the Masorah, in the side notes. So obviously these people were quite taken by big trees. As we see, flat earth and no force on a flat earth has everything to do with the scriptures. You know, it's very scriptural. I could go on for years, and I probably will, about the scriptures involved in, you know, in actually making note of and referring to Asherah, which is large trees that they saw as gods, and Satan himself being an Asherah, and flat earth references. Not that that's all important, but if it leads people to believe that the scriptures in general are true, this flat earth, no force movement might do, and in fact, many people are saying, has done more to turn scientists and people that never took the Bible seriously before to actually become Christian as they look and they see these giant mesas and petrified wood forests and all this evidence, the lack of